Signals are changing the way we do many things in Angular. You've likely encountered observables if you've worked in the framework for very long. They're a pretty handy way to stream values emitted over time to subscribers, providing a way to react to these events as needed. But often, when using them, we also need to trigger change detection in order to properly update items within views. With signals, observables are not being replaced. They still have use cases, but we can actually transform them into signals when needed. This can help with change detection and can often simplify the code overall. In this video, we'll convert a couple of observables from an existing example over to signals. All right, let's check it out. Now, before we get too far along, it's important to note that I have created another video where I cover the basics of signals, as well as the signal-based input function and the output function too. Also, the demo application that we'll use in this video uses the Angular CDK Breakpoint Observer, and you guessed it, I have a video on this as well. So if you're not too familiar with signals or the Breakpoint Observer, you may want to watch those videos first and then come back to this one so that it'll make more sense. Okay, enough of that. Onto the example for this video. Here we have a demo that I created for that video to demonstrate how the Angular CDK Breakpoint Observer works. As we resize, we can see that this label at the bottom of the viewport changes at certain points. It's either large, medium, or small. Also, when the viewport gets pretty small, the main nav is hidden and toggleable with this button in the upper right corner. If we toggle this menu open and then resize larger to where it's no longer toggleable, and then resize smaller to where it is toggleable again, we can see that it didn't remain open. Now, this exact functionality and the label change at the bottom is happening because of our use of the CDK Breakpoint Observer. Let's look at some code to see how. Here we're looking at code for our nav component. In this component, we have a current range variable. Then down here, we use the Breakpoint Observer to observe several breakpoints from the CDK layout module. This observe method returns an observable that fires anytime these breakpoints are first matched or unmatched. When the event fires, we are then simply checking each of our breakpoints to see which is matched and then setting our current range appropriately. When doing this, since we are using the on-push change detection strategy, we also need to use the change detector ref to properly update the view and show the appropriate label. So that's to show the label at the bottom. Next, we have an isVisible variable used to toggle the visibility of the menu when it's in smaller viewports. In order to force it to close when it's been opened and then the viewport has been resized larger, we're observing another breakpoint here to set it back to false when that occurs. So what we want to do is convert both of these over to signals. Let's start with the isVisible concept first. First, let's take a look at the template so we can fully understand what's happening. Here we can see the nav element gets a visible class when the isVisible property is true. Also, here on the button, we are simply toggling this property when it's clicked. And then here at the bottom, we are just string interpolating the value of the current range property. Okay, so that's what's going on in the template. Now let's go change some code. Okay, first thing we can do is move this breakpoint out to the class level and we'll make it private. Now we're going to create a signal from this observable. To do this, let's create a new private variable. Let's call it nav toggleable. Now we'll use the toSignal function, and we need to make sure it gets imported properly. The toSignal function will return a signal from an observable. The signal will always have the most recent value from the observable. Now we can take this whole subscription and move it into our toSignal function. Then let's add this dot to our breakpoint value so that we'll call the new variable. Now let's remove the take until destroyed here too. It won't be needed now. And now rather than subscribe, we're going to map the emitted value in order to return the value rather than a subscription. So let's remove the whole subscription. Then let's add the map operator and make sure it gets imported too. The observable will fire with the breakpoint state object, and we can simply return the state matches value. Also, we can add an options object here. Inside of this object, we could provide an initial value if we wanted, but in our case, this observable will produce a value immediately upon subscription. So we can instead add an option require sync with a value of true. Okay, so now we have a signal that will fire with a Boolean value every time the observe event fires. Now for this to all work properly, I'm going to add another protected variable here. Let's call it toggle visible. We'll use this variable to toggle the menu visibility when the button is clicked now. Let's set it to a signal using the signal function. And then let's give it an initial value of false. Now let's convert the isVisible property over to a signal using the computed function. We'll set this signal up to fire with a combination of the toggleVisible and the navToggleable signals. We'll only want to toggle the visibility if the nav is toggleable. So let's add a condition. If this dot nav toggleable. Now within this condition, we can just return the value of the toggle visible signal. And if the nav isn't toggleable, we just return false. So now our isVisible signal will only be able to change when the nav toggleable signal is true. In that case, it will be equal to the current value of the toggle visible signal. Okay, one more thing we need to do here. When our breakpoint observer fires, we want to set the toggle visible signal to false. This will just reset it to its initial state. Now we need to change a few things in the template, so let's switch to the HTML. First, we're going to do something totally different on click of the toggle button, so I'm going to clear this out. Next, we need to add parentheses everywhere isVisible is used. Okay, now on the button click, we want to set the toggle visible signal. And we'll set it to not equal its current value. Okay, now it should be toggleable. So let's save it and check it out. Before you can try this, you'll need to be in a viewport narrow enough that the menu is hidden. Then let's click to toggle the menu. Nice, it's opening and closing like we want. Now let's open it and then resize larger so that it becomes always visible. And now when we resize smaller, it should be closed. Let's try. Works as we'd expect, so we got everything right. So we've successfully converted that example over to signals. Now let's convert the current range example over to a signal too. This one should probably be a little more straightforward. We'll use toSignal here again. And let's copy the observe method with the breakpoints into the toSignal function. Now let's add dot pipe. And we'll use map again. Now we'll just add an empty callback. Within this callback, let's first check to see if we're matching the large breakpoint. If we are, we'll return a string value of large. Now let's add an else if and check if we're matching our median breakpoint. And if we are, we'll return a string of medium. And if neither of those are matched, let's return a value of small. Now let's also add require sync here too. And that's it. Now we can remove the ng-on-init method and everything in it. We can also remove the interface and the import too. And we don't need the change detector ref anymore either. We can remove the import for it. And we can also remove the take until destroyed import as well, since we're no longer using it either. So we were able to get rid of several things here, which is cool. Now we just need to fix the template where we're using the signal. Okay, that's it. Let's save and see if it's working correctly. Okay, so it looks like it's properly starting off with a value of small. And as we resize larger, we see medium, nice. And there's large. So it looks like everything is working correctly with signals now. So we didn't remove our observables, we just converted them to signals to make them easier to work with and to optimize change detection. You won't always need to convert observables over to signals in order to use them, but at least now you'll have a way to do it when needed. Now, like I said in my other video, there's still a lot more to signals, so who knows, maybe I'll create some more videos on them in the future. But that's it for now. Until next time, thanks for watching.